Boom, hey internets, we're talking about t-shirt production here, big subject on the channel, and specifically we're talking about doing screen printed t-shirts, right? So decorated or screen printed t-shirts on blanks. So we talk about transfers and a couple different techniques here. We're talking about traditional screen printing for this video, and big shout out to Foam Clothing. They reached out to me and said, what if a print color doesn't come out right for a final design? And then their follow-up question is, who is responsible? So I say on this channel all the time, and let me back up, if you don't know this or you haven't seen a video where I said this, I owned a high volume screen printing shop in Vista, California for over 3 years, where our biggest client was Blizzard. So we did a bunch of their printables, a lot of their stuff for BlizzCon, if you're familiar with the company. So I've produced a lot of shirts, not just on the design side of being a creative director for clothing companies, but I owned a shop where I would be the service provider for that type of operation on the other side of things. So I was servicing clients, so I know t-shirts very well. So first of all, when a vendor gets something wrong, we call that spoilage. Any good company should give you about 5% for spoilage, or they should say up front there could be up to 5% spoilage, which is misprints or maybe being off center a considerable amount. Any of those type of things. Maybe a t-shirt gets burned because they had to run it through a chamber. So anything that's an anomaly on one or two or three shirts, that is considered spoilage. Now, what if a vendor gets a color completely wrong? That's a huge problem. If all of the prints have an incorrect color, now you have to go back and see whose fault it was. Now, a lot of shops don't have a thorough process, right? Especially if it's a garage shop or a smaller mom and pop shop, they probably don't have ways where you approve the final design. You would have to be proactive to say, before you guys go ahead and screen all of the shirts, can you send me video footage or pictures of it on the press when you're the first two or three so I can approve it at that point? You would have to know that you should ask for that in the beginning. You should also think about doing it in an email so you have it in a recorded form, sort of. Not that you're gonna take it to small claims court, but it's just something to think about, to be very logistical and really just have your due diligence there. At our shop, we always had approval beforehand, which would deter these kind of mistakes, but very common for something like this to happen. So it's trying to find out if you guys communicated the right artwork to them. If you don't have tech packs, this is why I sell tech packs. One of my biggest items that sells on the shop is my tech packs, but the reason you have tech packs. Can you do a shirt without a tech pack? You can, but if you're literally emailing them and on the phone saying, hey, by the way, the color of that is a light blue and not navy, like the picture and that sort of thing, that's where it can be very dangerous because you're not being extremely exact about what you're giving them for the artwork, right? So if you look back and say, hey, this is what you emailed me, it was very vague or whatever, and maybe it was a verbal conversation, it's just hard to parse out. So like, if a shop really doesn't care about your returning business, they can definitely say this is your fault and not theirs if you can't prove it via emails and via your pre-communication prior to the production. Our shop, and I'm gonna be really honest with you guys, this is maybe why I left the business, we were really nice with our customers. We bent over backwards, so we would eat it if it was reasonably our fault. If it was reasonably our fault, we would eat it and we would run the production again, try to get it within the same timelines. So that means we effectively lose money on that job in order to gain their faith and full confidence for the next time if it was our fault. But if you did determine it's the shop's fault, they should do the same thing and they should run the whole thing back. A lot of shops, what they will do at that point and what we would do is try to convince you to buy the ones that are duds if they're still good otherwise, but the color choice was just incorrect. We would offer those t-shirts to them at the cost of the blanks, so at least we don't incur the cost of the blanks because we're not gonna do anything with them, or we could try to do a warehouse sale where you sell them for the cost of the shirt. That's very common. But if you're dealing with a big company like Blizzard, like I talked about before, you can't do that with their product. So in those scenarios, imagine if you had 2,000 shirts that were incorrect. You would basically eat that cost. You'd have to destroy those shirts. Is there a chance that the shop will not rerun that product? For sure. I've definitely heard horror stories, and I early on got jacked by a screen printing shop that literally disappeared. So took maybe $800 worth of blanks and literally left the building, dead phone number, the whole thing. Never really talked about that in this channel, but that was unfortunate and horrible, but it happens. So this will be a test of your relationship with that screen printer to see how they react. But if it is their fault, they should do the right thing and do it over. And they're gonna offer you those blanks for you to buy. That would be up to you. If you think they're still sellable, even though they're not exactly the correct design, I think it would be good to take the shirts. We wouldn't even make money. We just wouldn't want to lose as much money on those shirts. But that's a scenario that would happen in my experience. If you are getting set to design shirts or hats or maybe your first drop. I put a course together, pretty cohesive course about the fundamentals of putting a brand together, but we're gonna start with blanks for hats and t-shirts. Check out this course, I have the link for it below. If you had any other questions around this, you can also drop those in the comments as you give it a like. You could also hit me at this number here, it gets me directly, and we can text back and forth some of your questions. Hope that helps. I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye.